In the mid-afternoon hours of May 11th of 2023, a fairly sizable moderate magnitude earthquake struck a section of northeastern California. At 4:19 p.m. local time, this earthquake occurred, causing the ground to shake over a wide area, which registered in as a magnitude 5.5. This quake was centered 9.5 miles southeast of the city of Chester, originating beneath a section of Lake Alamanor. It caused moderate damage to some structures, causing some items to fall off of shelves at nearby shops and triggering minor landslides which reportedly blocked a section of Highway 89. Yet, the minor to moderate damage this quake caused is not why it is in the news, but rather due to its close proximity to the Lassen Peak volcano, which produced the last volcanic eruption in the state of California between 1914 and 1917. The Lassen Peak volcanic complex has been active for approximately 3.5 million years, and today is still quite active despite not erupting in more than a century. Even today, Lassen Peak still contains an active at-depth magma chamber as shown by the abundant gas and geothermal vents it has. The magnitude 5.5 earthquake which occurred was centered 28 miles southeast of Lassen Peak, and approximately 10 hours later, a magnitude 5.2 quake struck the same area. Despite the proximity of these quakes to Lassen Peak, they were luckily occurring in the wrong location to be caused by volcanic activity. Thus, these two large quakes were not caused by the influx of magma and did not represent volcano tectonic quakes, meaning they did not affect the Lassen Peak volcano, Mount Shasta, or any of California's other active volcanoes. Rather, they were completely non-volcanic, being tectonic in origin. For context, a section of California encompasses the western edge of the Basin and Range province, where the crust is slowly extending to the east and west, forming a series of valleys and moderate elevation high point mountains. This is why a large swath of Nevada has a series of landforms which seemingly repeat, while also including a series of lengthy fault lines which parallel many of these straight-line ridges. While Lake Alamanor is not in the Basin and Range province, the crust around it has been loosely affected by forces caused by extension to the east, creating a series of northwest to southeast trending fault lines. Yet, you might note that the two moderate magnitude 5 quakes did not occur on a known fault line. This is because they occurred on a blind fault, that is, a fault line which we did not know existed, but it makes sense it does exist due to the large number of moderate length fault lines in the vicinity. The magnitude 5.5 and 5.2 earthquakes occurred at 3.6 and 3.8 miles depth respectively, originating due to the slippage of what was likely an approximately 3-mile long section of a normal fault line where the hanging wall slid down and away from the footwall. Since 1949, a total of 224 earthquakes of magnitude 2.5 or higher have occurred within or adjacent to Lake Alamanor, including an even larger magnitude 5.7 quake that struck on May 24, 2013. Other felt quakes include a June 1989 magnitude 4.3, an August 1949 magnitude 4.5, and a magnitude 3.9 quake in January of 1978. What I am trying to say is that tectonic quakes are fairly common around Lake Alamanor, and an instance with a larger magnitude 5.7 quake in 2013 did not affect the Lassen Peak volcano, and the same is the case with the May 2023 quakes. As for the other 20 earthquakes which have occurred in the aftermath of the two magnitude 5 events, these are merely aftershocks, which are occurring at the expected rate of 1 over x, where x represents the amount of minutes which have passed since the main quake. Thus, an aftershock is 1/10 as likely to occur 500 minutes after the main quake than it is to occur 50 minutes after the main shock quake. And this is one of the 50% of aftershock sequences where the largest aftershock, the magnitude 5.2, was larger than the statistical average of the largest aftershock being 1.2 orders of magnitude lower on average than the main quake. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.